Fabio, will you? Come on.
Give me four minutes.
Fabio. We're 2 minutes late now. Come on.
Give me 4 minutes.
No,
please.
Fabio.
Oh, yes. Oh,
no,
yes.
Fabio. This is the way you are with me whenever I'm late.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are exactly like this.
The difference is I'm going to be 5 minutes late.
Fabio, will you hurry up?
You're always
going to be late.
Before.
We're going to be late, Fabio. Oh, my God. We're going to be late. It's terrible. Oh, my God. Fabio, 4 minutes. 4 minutes is just not good enough. We're on our way to Sitges for the week. Sitges, Barcelona, and Spain.
Just a spelling off. Spelling off the edge of the camera.
E-N-E-G-H.
Oh, yes.
So we're on our way to Sitges now. Fabio, whenever I am remotely late, acts exactly like this. So I'm just paying back because we're a couple of minutes late. We're supposed to leave at 11 o'clock. It's now 5 past 11.
No, it's 3 past 11.
Come on, Fabio. Oh, my God. We're on our way to Sitges. We're going to the airport, Faroe Airport, to get our plane for a week with our friends in the sun. Are you looking forward to it, Fabio?
As we are not in the sun here.
Are you looking forward to Sitges?
I am, yeah. But we are leaving the sun to go to the sun. We're just going for friends. We're not going because of the sun.
Yes, it's sunny here. Yes, obviously we are going into Sitges to more sun, to actually drier sun, or no, more moist sun, isn't it?
No, it's just very humid in there. Yeah. It's not in here.
Yeah, one of the great things about living in the Alps, it's not really that humid. It's you get great breezes and you never feel really sticky. You know, even though it's fairly warm, you don't feel really sticky. But in Spain, you tend to feel a bit close. So anyway, but who cares? We're going to have a great time and meet our friends, hang out, have nice food, and party. We got here to Sitges. We are here and we are turn the camera out, girls.
Hello.
That's Paul and there's Sosh.
Oh, hi.
And they got a beautiful apartment here, I have to say. It's really just right smack in the centre of Sitges. Nice big apartment, which we're delighted about. And Serge and Paul very kindly gave us the ensuite, which is really nice. They've been here for a night. So there's the ensuite in our bedroom there, which is really nice. And then I'll show you the rest of the apartment. It's a big old apartment. This is a room-like area here, and the kitchen in here. Oh, great, an iron, fabulous. And then into the sitting room, which is a really nice big sitting room, and onto the really nice balcony as well, so that's lovely. And then we have a swimming pool too, really nice. Oh. Finally got here, so for some fun and games here in Sitges, can't wait to go downtown and see everybody and dress up and look nice and just get the general vibe of Sitges. Doing a video and my husband keeps telling me I have a ball patch on the back of my head.
You can just see it here, look at the ball patch, look.
There is no ball patch on my head.
There is, and it's burnt.
I am going grey.
No, it's not grey, it's lack of hair.
Shut your mouth. Anyway. This is lovely. So this is the way we're starting off our Sitges experiences, with my husband basically berating me the whole entire time and telling me how ugly I am and how he doesn't love me and so on. So that's basically it. So I'm just going to stay here and
Ken is staying in.
Yeah, I'm staying in. I'm not going out tonight. I'm not going to go and enjoy myself because, you know, what's the point when your husband hates you? 17 years together and that's the way it is.
Have a drink,
Ken. I will.
Top of war. Thanks. Ken, if your phone has chocolate at the back.
Oh.
No, that's poo. That's actually poo. So that's not chocolate.
I'm going to ask you to put your hand after.
No chocolate. Our first night out in Sitges. For those of you who don't know, Sitges is sort of like a... I'm going to sneeze.
Oh, yeah.
Oh fuck, I sneeze again. Jesus. For people who don't know, Sitges is sort of like a gay town, really, in Spain, just outside Barcelona. And it's really good fun. And there'll be lots of people around, and lots of drinking, and lots of fun, and lots of cuteness, and we'll have a really good time. So, this is what I'm wearing.
That's why Ken doesn't come here very often.
Shut your mouth, you gay old man. That's what I'm wearing, and this is what he's wearing. It looks like a bodysuit for a dead person. But anyway, so I will record as the night goes on, and you can see what goes on.
Not hungry at all.
Are you not?
No. Right.
The girls are here. Let's see if you can find a spot over there.
Grab there, look.
Good morning. Well, 12 o'clock. So we are going to head down to the beach now. We are going to, I think it's called Picnic Beach, or the beach is just down on the main sort of area, which I'll show you now in a minute, here in Sitges. And we're going to go and sunbathe and look at the wildlife. and then maybe go for lunch afterwards. But last night we had an early night. We literally went out for one drink and then came home, and all of us were wrecked. So we came home and we slept, and we've been out a couple of times this morning just to get food and stuff like that, and feeling much better after drinking about 5 liters of water. But yeah, can't wait for the day. It's a beautiful day here in Sitges again, as usual. So we're gonna go out and enjoy our afternoon. So talk to you in a bit. So here we are on the beach in Sitges. This is on the main beach, which is, there is a pier which I'm walking along right now. And this half to my left, great beach. And then this half to my right is the gay beach. So I'm in the middle. I'm Canada. It's a beautiful day. We're actually sitting on the straight side because it's too packed on the other side, and also there's a lot of smokers and stuff. So Fabio is completely anti-smoking, so it's sometimes difficult if people are smoking around you. But I'm going to turn the camera and show you what it is like. Show you what the beach is like, and also the church at the top of Mykonos. The top of Sitges is just here to my left. It's really famous, so I'll show you that now. So there's the church, a beautiful church, which we'll go for a walk later on. And this is the beach. And then this is the other side of the beach. So this is one of many beaches here in Sitges, and all the hotels there along the promenade. This is Picnic Bar just here, where we're going to go for lunch now in a minute. We've been coming here for years. I've been here since I was, I think like 20. So we've been coming here a long time over the years, and I have to say I love it here. Fabio's not so keen. He doesn't sort of understand the whole reason why you would come back and go to the same place, but because we meet our mates and our friends and we get to be who we want to be, because it's very, very gay friendly here, and you can, you know, there's no fear of holding your husband's hand or getting abuse or anything like that. It's just a really great place because of that. And also you really can just be who you want to be here, and we love that. Hello.
We are here. We're here in Picnic Bar and we're having a bit of an altercation. It's going to be a fight.
This person here is trying to desperately to force his will on us as individuals, and we're not going to be forced. We've lived in the closet for long enough. We're not living in it anymore.
Ken has a hangover from hell.
And so does Serge.
Can I wave to my fan?
You can.
Hi to my fan.
These are some of my favourite things. Fried chilies or peppers.
No, they are chilies, they are peppers.
Fried peppers. Okay, shut up. Fried peppers with a beer.
They're mine.
In a picnic bar.
What?
Nothing. Just filming.
Look at the lamps, can I tell you are gorgeous in the past
today. How are you now?
Good.
What are you feeling?
Feeling good. I'm feeling good.
It's nice to be out with your husband.
It's nice to be out with my husband, but that could be anywhere, not necessarily here.
But it is nice to be together.
It is nice to be together.
Nice to be able to walk down the street arm in arm.
But you can't dash anywhere, no, even at home. Even at home.
No. One o'clock in the morning is way past our bedtime. We never stay up this late. I'm normally in bed by 9 o'clock. But when you are in Sitges and you've had a couple of drinks, I haven't had that many, but when you've had a couple of drinks, this is where you go to. You have your pizza, little pizza slices, and you eat them as you're walking along arm in arm with your husband. So we could go out, we could go to clubs and things like that, but well, we're not really clubby people anymore, but in the next couple of days, we will stay out later than 1 o'clock. I hope. Love is love. Love is love, Fabio. Love is love.
Love is love.
So we're on our way to Falmouth Beach, which is down the prom a little bit.
Miles away.
So, coming up to the beautiful church, which is the vocal, which is the
focal point
of Sitges.
Not the vocal, the focal.
And again, last night we went out to party and we only had one drink and then we were too tired, so we went back to bed. We went home to bed, had a good night's sleep, and now we're going to the beach. Going to Fabio, and we look like twans.
Yeah.
Look like twans.
Yeah. You want to.
But, you know, the main thing is, love is love. We'll be right back. if you don't mind.
Just go to the church.
Yes,
you know where
you're
leaving. Go to the church.
I do know where I'm
leaving. Probably 2 days' time.
Good. Get you off my back. Wow, look at that.
I need something to come back when I'm walking to the air face in the wall to see how good it is.
Fabulous, so beautiful. So we're walking through the streets of Sitges, which is one of the most beautiful places
the
I've ever been to.
Yeah, show them the streets.
So
the
gorgeous.
Show them the streets, Kevin. Watch your face. Actually, you know what?
Say hello. We are back from the beach. It's been a couple of hours and we are now having our delicious pizza, which we just ordered, which we just went and got. Delicious pizza. And we've got some chic, nasty, sparkling wine, which we're just about to drink.
It's warm.
Warm. And we're gonna... There's Fabio. Hello. We're just about to, we're going to go out on the town and paint the town red.
Purple.
So it is Tuesday and we are off to our friend Martin's and Wallace's apartment, which they're renting for the next couple of weeks for a party. So it has been a lovely day, very warm, and I'm at the stage where I'm a little bit tired, but you know, that's just the way it is when you come to Sitges. So we will film and record. That's my father. Sorry, my grandfather. but I'll show you what we are getting up to as the day goes on, or the evening.
We are in our friend
Martin and Wallace's apartment. It's a fantastic apartment. Here, I'll show you the. They're right on the main area here. We know any women, so we don't know any women. So. It is the morning after the night before. So we had a fantastic night, as you saw last night. I think I recorded it, I can't really remember. But we had a great time, and now we are just, it's lunchtime actually, it's 12 o'clock. And as you can probably hear, I sound a little bit hoarse. So we are going to take it easy today. We're not doing an awful lot, probably wander around. And there is a few stages being set up here in Sitges because it's Pride Week. So there's a stage just down this direction, which I'll show you. And it kicks off, I think, tonight with a drag show. So we'll probably have a look at that and see how that is. And then tomorrow is our good friend Marcus's birthday. So we're going out for dinner. And that'll be another debaucherous night. And then Friday, we'll probably take it easy. And then Saturday, I come home and I'm back straight into work. So I've got a wedding straight away. So I'm having a great time, but I'm also looking forward to going home. I miss my dog. And I'm worried about my plants all dying. So hopefully they haven't, I hope. So I will talk to you later on. So just getting ready for Pride.
Cool.
So what? I love to celebrate these things.
summer, yes, what a week. So I thank and thank you, Sitges.
Probably one of the most iconic things in Sitges is the beautiful church, especially at night time. Everybody, so it is our second to last day here in Sitges, which we're sad about, but it's our friend's birthday, so we're just off to meet them for dinner. I just wanted to show this beautiful hotel. This is the Hotel Sitges. It's been here since 1883, as you can see, and it's a beautiful old gay hotel here in Sitges. And then it continues on here as well, and the facade is just beautiful. It's really, really famous, and it is probably the first hotel I ever stayed in when I came to Sitges 2 years ago. But there's that across the way, though. Beautiful garden there. So look at that hotel. Hey, nice to see you all. Happy birthday. I know we shouldn't, but we did.
Also gay, myself and Ken, just for fun. You have to open it.
Yes, you do. Open the bloody thing. Open it now.
Rip the bag.
I just, my 300 followers will see it. That's all. So this is your pride rig out. It's your pride rig out.
Yes, and there's the bottom part as well.
Are they matching?
Oh, they're nice.
Look what's written on them.
Easy and cheap.
Cheap and easy.
Yeah, cheap and easy.
Happy birthday. This is the last night of us in Sitges for this particular time. Did you enjoy yourself, Bobby?
I did.
Did you really enjoy yourself?
I did.
Fabio has a love-hate relationship with Sitges, and he comes here because of me. But I love it, and I love the atmosphere, and I love the partying, and I love all of that. But I am ready to go home. A week here is enough.
Past week.
What?
Past week.
Yeah. No, it's enough. Because I want to get home to my dog and see if my plants are still
you
alive.
Can't hear because it's still.
Oh yeah, I'm going to turn this around so you can see the back of the stage. Sort of the kicking off of Pride. Tomorrow there's a march on, but anyway.